For more information, see the description below. Namaste.
Should I write yoga or just yoga?
Yoga. Yujyate iti yoga. Yujyate iti yoga.
That which is joined.
That which joins. So to study yoga, you should have the knowledge about Adhikarana. Otherwise, you cannot make it. Understood? So Adhikarana is always there in every Tantra Yukti. You cannot learn the other Tantra Yukti without the knowledge of the yoga. Right. Yoga. What they told yoga, you see? See? Yogo Nama. Yogo Nama.
What is it? 1 minute.
You read this completely. Let us complete Adhikarana perfectly.
Okay.
Why to enter into Adhikarana? Adhikarana you complete perfectly. Come on.
So we are here.
We start.
Tatra. Shastra.
Shastram.
Where is Am?
Shastra. Shastradhikaranam.
Okay. Tatra Shastradhikaranam.
Shastradhikaranam.
Yadadi.
Krutya.
Shastram. Pravartate. Pravartate.
See, Ayurveda is a adhikaranam. Ayurvedam, the term Ayurvedam is a Adhikarana.
Okay.
Why it is called Adhikarana, you tell me?
Because it's a Shastra.
It is a Shastra explaining about?
Ayu.
So Ayurveda is a Adhikarana under which?
We are going to talk about Ayu.
Correct.
Okay.
So it is called Shastra Adhikarana. We can call it as Shastra Adhikarana.
Okay.
Okay.
Should I keep reading?
See, it is a type of Adhikarana. Shastra Adhikarana is a type of Adhikarana.
Okay.
What is then Shastra Adhikarana? Shastra Adhikarana is the text which explaining about...
Not the text, the science.
Is a text which explaining about...
A science.
A science.
Okay.
Then it is called Shastra Adhikarana.
Okay.
Okay.
So we are going to keep on Adhikarana yet.
Adhikarana, yes. Because then yoga will be easy, that is why.
Okay.
So the Adhikarana can be called as Shastra Adhikarana, then a particular science is explained under which.
Okay.
A particular science is explained under which, then as then we can call it as a Shastra Adhikarana.
Okay.
Clear?
Yes.
Next one, you read.
Tata Ashtavanga Vanganya
Adhikritya Adhikritya
Hridayakhyam. Where is that? These are.
That is 3 is the reference number. Sarvam.
Okay. Sarvam. Shastram. Prakru.
Pravrtam.
Oh, this is V. Okay. Pravrtam.
Understood? This is a science which is explaining about the 8 types of
Adhikaram.
8. Ashtavangani. It is explaining about the 8 parts of Ayurveda.
Okay.
So that is why the whole textbook is called Adhikarana of the 8 parts of a science.
Okay.
Clear?
Okay.
Clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Next you read.
Tata.
Yatho.
Okay. Yatho.
Kaya Bala Understood. That sloga is told in the beginning.
Ityadi.
Ityadi means etc.
Etc.
That complete sloga you recall?
Kayabala grahor gonga shaladamstra jaravrushan.
Ashtavangani.
Tasya
ahu kasya.
Chikitsa yeshu.
Tasya ahu. What is the meaning of tasya?
Ashtav.
His. Tasya, the word meaning of tasya is his.
Okay.
Whose. If you do not know the context, you cannot tell the meaning of tasya. Whose.
The book, the Ayurveda has this.
Tasya means of the Ayurveda.
Okay.
Correct?
Yes.
How did you understand it? Because you know that this science is explaining about
Ayurveda.
Ayurveda. That's why the meaning of tasya is of Ayurveda.
Okay.
Okay. So Ayurveda is the science explaining about the eightfold divisions of it.
Okay. What I'm getting this from all this is that if we don't know the name of the chapter,
it is very difficult to understand
the name of the book.
No doubt. It is very difficult to understand.
You cannot understand.
That's
properly.
Why if you ask me a sloga, immediately I ask, where from you took this? Okay. I will ask. You may tell it is from yoga. Sorry, Bhagavad Gita. Then I will ask which chapter it belongs.
Okay.
Immediately well, otherwise I should not give the meaning to you because it will be misleading. No doubt. Even I will ask you which chapter I will ask you. Because otherwise it is very difficult. Giving meaning is dangerous. It will give you sometimes opposite meaning.
Yes.
No doubt in that one. No doubt in that one.
Okay.
We are not supposed to explain. Immediately we have to ask where from you have taken it. Context is very important. Adhikaranam is very important. No doubt. That's a mistake when you are alone reading the textbook and understanding the text.
We don't have any book in English
like
of Tantra Yogi.
He is giving lot of meaning lists, I think. Yes, he is giving. He is giving everything. Perfectly he is giving. But little bit misguiding is there, that's why. The translations he has made little bit. He mixed 2-3 ideas together. But it's okay, fine. See? Tantra Yogi Adhikaranam. The subject matter of a science in general. That's the meaning he is giving. Tantra Adhikarana. See, the subject matter of a science in general. That is, Ayurveda is the subject matter in general. The larger sense. That's why it is called Tantra Adhikarana. Shastra Adhikarana. Grantha Adhikarana. He is dividing you, see, Adhikaranas. Understood? Then, subject matter of a particular treatise. That means this is a grantha.
Yes.
Ayurveda is totally tantra. Tantra. This is a grantha. So it is having a adhikarana. That is grantha adhikarana.
Okay.
Okay. Sthana adhikarana. Sutra sthana is a couple.
Okay.
Like this, he is dividing and giving it. He is giving. Adhyaya adhikarana. You see. Subject matter of a chapter. That is adhyaya adhikarana.
So he included grantha here.
Yeah, that is grantha.
Here it is, he did not use. Yeah, okay.
Grantha.
Okay.
Okay. Now next one you read sthana adhikarana. Sthana adhikaranam yata. Sthana adhikarana means sutra sthana is a sthana. Come on. Atra.
Atrartha. Ha.
Sutrita.
Sutrita. Ha. Sukshmaha
pratanyante
hi
sarvataha. You know what is the meaning of that? You should know that. Then only you'll understand what is sutrasthana. Tell me.
Atra artaha
means vishaya.
Atra artaha.
Here. The topics.
Okay.
Sutrita. What is the meaning of sutrita? Threaded.
Okay.
Sewed together.
Okay.
Threaded.
Sukshmaha.
Sukshmaha. What is the meaning of sukshmaha? In the subtlest form.
Okay.
Hmm.
Sukshmaha.
Pratanyante. Pratanyante.
It's like to make a cloth.
Okay.
He.
Sarvadaha, bro. From everywhere. From everywhere, so, I took the topics.
And you're going to make a comprehensive
and made them very sukshma. And made them very sukshma. And after that, I joined them. That is why this sthana is called sutrasthana.
Just like you have the cotton, and then you have the thread, and then you have the shirt. So you have one thing that is very gross, and you need to make it more sukshma, make like the thread, and the, in the thread you can join them in a specific manner that you have the comprehension of the whole thing.
That is what is you are telling, how a text is created. I am speaking about sutrasthana. Sutrasthana is the concise summary of remaining all chapters.
Okay.
Sutrasthana includes Nidanasthana, Sharirasthana, Chikilsasthana, Siddhisthana. Every subject matter is made into its subtlest form and created the Sutrasthana. That's why it is called Sutrasthana. This is the definition for Sutrasthana, not for every sthana.
Okay.
Sutridaha is made into sutra, is made into the subtlest sutra. What? Sarvataha artaha. Artaha means topics. Sarvataha means from everywhere. So if you simply study the sutrasthana in a perfect manner, you don't have to study.
Because you can...
You can explain from here, you can explain everything.
Like when we take a big thing in the computer and we zip it.
Correct. So zip is actually sutrasthana. Okay. That is what is he meant for that. So sthana is also a adhikarana. Clear? Next one.
Adhyaya P.
Adhikarana. See, adhyaya also can be called as an adhikarana. Adhyaya means, what is the meaning of adhyaya?
It's chapter. Adhyayopi yada dikara dikrutya.
Yada dikrutya. Strong. Yada dikrutya together. Then only you can split it as yada adhikrutya.
Yada adhikrutya.
Otherwise, what will happen? Yada adhikrutya you will read. Then where from you will get
Okay. Yada adhikrutya. Pravartati.
Pravartate means?
Pravartate.
Acts or exist. That's the meaning of pravartate.
Tadadhyayadhikaranam.
That is adhyayadhikaranam. So how will you name a chapter? Simple example. How will you name a chapter? Tell me. Dinacharya, how did you name the chapter?
He's getting the most important topic that is relating to the whole chapter. That is...
So, whether you have... One minute. You are a person, okay? This is very important. You're going to write a book.
Okay.
You will give the name of the chapter first, or you will think about the subject matter has to be explained. Which one you will think?
As we are speaking, I believe we need
You're a writer. Okay. You'll write a book.
In the West, may be different. But as we are speaking here, the name of the chapter needs to come first.
Then what will you do?
All the things that are inside this topic will be allowed to stay in the chapter. The other ones will need to be passed to another chapter.
So when you are writing a thesis, coming to the research, when you are writing a thesis, first, what will you write? The heading of the thesis you will write. You will decide the topics for the thesis, right?
In a perfect world, yes.
Right? Now I'm asking, how will you write it into a thesis book form? What will be the next step?
You have to know which sthanas there will be. And then what...
Your topic is about the properties of a drug. You are doing this, which are the properties of this drug and the diseases which can be managed by this drug. You are going to make a study on a particular herb.
Okay.
Tell me, how will you write it into a thesis form?
I will look first for the names of the herb, okay, and then the botanical description of the herbs.
Very good.
And then the pharmacological actions of the herb.
Very good.
And then the synergetic effects of this herb with another.
Very good.
The contraindications with this herb with another thing.
So you will arrange the chapter accordingly.
Okay.
Each chapter, right? Then you, what you will do, you will name the chapter and you will collect the data suitable for that chapter. Am I right?
Okay.
So each chapter can be called as an adhikarana for you.
Okay.
Okay. Under that chapter also, again, what will you do? The chapter you will divide it into 5-6 prakaranas.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So in this way, is the way it is chapter adhikarana, adhyaya adhikarana.
Okay.
Next one. No, why I asked the question, because see, Ayushkami, he gave the first name of the chapter. Dinacharya is the second chapter. But Dinacharya is also to be understood for the longevity of life. Then why did he include that one in the first chapter and he put it as a separate chapter? You have to justify.
Because it's going
then
to
only
be,
you understood Adhikarana completely.
Because if he put everything in the first chapter,
your mind is going na. You just imagine. Vayoho Ratri Uktanam, Tendamadhya Adhika Krama, he included in the first chapter.
Yes.
So second chapter is going to be speaking about the different activities which are going to affect the body. So he gave the hint in the first chapter.
Okay.
Because day, night, etc. has influence in the Ayushkami. Yes, already included
yes.
that one.
Yeah.
But one topic he want to explain in detail, that is why
another chapter.
He has included that idea in this first chapter, there is no doubt.
Okay.
He included Ritu, he included Dina, everything in the first chapter, you see. Everything related to Ayus is included in the first chapter. But he wanted to explain in detail, so he chose another
Just
chapter.
Like when we are reading in Wikipedia and there is hyperlinks and we click and there is
Yes, same. Clear? Dinacharya is also coming under Ayushkamiyam only. But Ayushkamiyam gives only the sukshma forms of them. Then each one he wanted to explain, that's why again he has divided it into. I hope you understood now.
Okay.
Adhyaya Adhikarana, you got it? Next
yes.
one.
We are in Tata.
Mm.
Ayato.
Athato. What is this dear?
Okay. Athato.
Dinacharyam adhyayam.
Dinacharya adhyayam.
Vyakhyasyamaha. Very clear. In that chapter he should not include Ritu. Because that chapter is related to
Dinacharya.
Right? So any line in that chapter I should understand only with reference to a day. I should never understand it on the basis of Ritu. Clear? So it is Adhyaya Adhikarana, there is no doubt.
Okay.
Next one.
Why there is this iti here and tata? Sometimes there is iti, sometimes there is tata.
Iti means like this. Whenever you give an example, at the end they will give iti.
Okay. For example, it's...
Symbol. They will give the whole news. Iti vartaha. They will tell. Whatever I told now, it can be called as today's news.
Okay. And tatha?
Tatha means like that. I explain one topic. Like that, I explain sthana adhikarana. Like that, I am going to explain adhyaya adhikarana. Like that, I am going to explain prakarana adhikarana. Like that, I am going to explain vakya adhikarana. So for that, tatha.
Okay.
Okay.
Prakaranam yadadi kritya.
Pravartate
tat.
Tat prakaranadi.
Tad?
Tat.
Tat. Okay. Prakaranadhyaya.
Prakaranadhikaranam.
Prakaranadhikaranam.
That is called prakaranadhikaranam. I told you now what is prakaranadhikaranam.
Okay.
Collection of slokas which are going to explain a particular subject matter, then we can call it as prakaranadhikaranam.
Okay.
Dasha.
Dasha
Mula Sira
Dasha Mula
Sira.
Mula Sira. Hrut.
Hrut.
Hrut Sia. Hrut Sta. Sta Staha.
Sarvam.
Sarvam. Sarvato.
Vapuhu.
Vapuhu.
This is Sharirasthana, one of the sloka.
Okay.
Okay. From there he is starting. Ityadi. From his he is starting. Then he is ending the topic. You see. Ityeva. Right.
Here. Okay.
Iti.
Iti.
Ityadi.
Ityadi.
Like this. Begins with. Adi means begins.
Okay.
Like this he begins and then yavat. Till that.
Yavat.
Till which one more line he will call.
Okay. Ityavedhya
vimagartam.
Vimagartam.
Vibhagartam.
Ba?
That is bha. Vibhagartam.
Okay. Sorry. Vibhagartam. Vibhagartam.
Pratyangam.
Pratyangam.
Varnitaha.
Varnitaha.
Siraha.
Siraha. So this,
this is begin with this loka,
okay.
Ending with this loka, it is a
prakarana. Okay. This we have studied.
Yeah. Ityadi. Ityadi again I told you. If a topic is given immediately at the end, what they will do? Like this. Like this. Like this means this is one example. Like this you can get many. Evam.
Evam.
Vakyamavi.
Vakyamapi
yadadikritya pravartate
pravartate
tat vakya
adhikaranam
tad vakya
adhikaranam tad vakya adhikaranam
vedyam. You know what is the meaning of vedyam? To be understood. Viditam yogyam
vedyam.
Viditam yogyam vedyam, to be understood. So like this, in a sentence also you can get adhikarana. Okay, now
okay.
I am going to tell you. Listen me carefully. Vayu pittam kavascheri trayo guna samas, trayo dosha samasada.
Okay.
Okay. How will you get the meaning of that sentence? It's a vakya. How will you understand the meaning of that context?
We need to understand the
Anvaya.
The Anvaya.
Right.
Not the chapter, not
nothing. How will you write the Anvaya? How will you tell me the Anvaya of that one?
It's going to be Vayuscha.
Vayu, you don't have to add anything. Vayu, pittam, kapaha, cha.
Cha, okay.
Cha.
Samasataha. Trayo doshaha.
Trayaha doshaha.
Trayaha doshaha.
Not completed. Sentence is not completed. Trayaha doshaha.
Bhavanti.
Correct. Bhavanti. So what you have done? You connected lines, words in such a way to get the complete meaning. That connectivity is called Vichadandra Yukti. Next Chadandra Yukti. What is the next
Yoga.
One?
Okay.
Okay.